Hello everyone. In this video, we will do the daily current affairs analysis of the news items which were on news on 5th of October 2021. So the topics which we will discuss are the prohibition of chemical weapons OPCW and the prohibited chemicals in firecrackers. Next news item is the Real Estate Regulatory Authority RERA Act of 2016. And next we will discuss the Nobel Medicine Prize which have been recently announced. Next is the drone based vaccine delivery model launched in Manipur by the CSIR, and also the exercise Milan which is undertaken by the Indian Navy. We will discuss about that. So first is the prohibition of chemical weapons OPCW. It is important for GS paper 2, and topic is important international institutions, agencies and fora, their structure and mandate. So why it is in news? The conference on disarmament is being held in Geneva. So at the conference, India expressed deep concern over the proliferation of weapons of mass destruction and their delivery systems that could endanger peace and security, saying the possibility of terrorists acquiring such weapons necessitates the global community to work together to address the grave danger. So there has been an enhanced focus on anti-terrorism initiatives, because terrorism is a global concern. All the countries, whether the developed countries or the developing countries, all of them face the issues posed by terrorists. So they have to deal with that collectively. Then only the issues posed by terrorist activities can be dealt with in an effective manner. So India has said that it supports the full and effective implementation of the Chemical Weapons Convention and emphasizes the strengthening of the OPCW to fulfill its important mandate. So about the Conference on Disarmament. The Conference on Disarmament, CD, is a multilateral disarmament forum established by the international community to negotiate arms control and disarmament agreements based at the Palais des Nations in Geneva. The conference meets annually in three separate sessions in Geneva. The conference was first established in 1979 as the Committee on Disarmament, as the single multilateral disarmament of the international community. It was renamed the Conference on Disarmament in 1984. Formation was it was formed in 1984, and current members are 65 countries are members of this conference, and the conference was created with a permanent agenda also known as the Decalogue, which includes the following topics: nuclear weapons in all aspects, other weapons of mass destruction, conventional weapons, reduction of military budgets, reduction of armed forces, disarmament and development, disarmament and international security, relationship with the United Nations. The conference is formally independent from the United Nations. However, while it is not formally a United Nations organization, it is linked to it in various ways. First and foremost, the Director General of the United Nations Office at Geneva serves as the Secretary General of the conference. Furthermore, while the conference adopts its own rules of procedure and agenda, the United Nations General Assembly can pass resolutions recommending specific topics to the conference. Finally, the conference submits a report of its activities to the General Assembly yearly or more frequently as appropriate. So about the OPCW, it is an international organization established by the Chemical Weapons Convention 1977 to implement and enforce the terms of the Non-Proliferation Treaty, which prohibits the use, stockpiling or transfer of chemical weapons by signatory states. So as we have seen that in the recent few times, instances of chemical terrorism has also been on the rise, because terrorists have been looking for new ways to cause destruction, and chemical usage of chemical weapons, usage of chemical substances to cause havoc among the large masses of people has been their new tool, because with the usage of chemical substances, they can have a larger target, and also, you know, they can both in quantitative terms also and qualitative terms also, like geographical extent also is large in case of chemical substances, and the number of people who are expected to be affected by those chemical substances is also large. So that is why the usage of chemical substances as you know, explosives has been on the rise in the recent few times, and that is why their usage has to be brought under control in order to better mitigate the dangers posed by the terrorist organizations. So the OPCW is authorized to perform inspections to verify that signatory states are complying with the convention. By the 2001 relationship agreement between the OPCW and the United Nations, the OPCW reports on its inspections and other activities to the UN through the Office of the Secretary General. The organization was awarded the 2013 Nobel Peace Prize for its extensive efforts to eliminate chemical weapons. The Chemical Weapons Convention prohibits developing, producing, acquiring, stockpiling, or retaining chemical weapons. The direct or indirect transfer of chemical weapons. Chemical weapons use or military preparation for use, assisting, encouraging, or inducing other states to engage in CWC prohibited activity. The use of riot control agents as a method of warfare. External auditor for Hague-based OPCW. In April 2021, India's Comptroller and Auditor General CAG has been chosen as the external auditor by the Prohibition of Chemical Weapons OPCW for a three-year term starting 2021. The appointment was made through an election process at the OPCW conference recently. India was also selected as the member of the Executive Council of the OPCW, representing Asia Group, for another two-year term during the OPCW conference. About the Executive Council, it is the governing body of the OPCW. The Council consists of 41 OPCW member states that are elected by the Conference of the States Parties and rotates every 2 years. The Council supervises the activities of the Technical Secretariat and is responsible for promoting the effective implementation of and compliance with the Convention. Each member state has the right on a rotating basis to serve on the Executive Council. So, prelim shortlink topics are about OPCW, what is CWC, its members, functions of the Executive Council, and roles and functions of the external auditor of OPCW. And this is the source link where you can read the original article. Okay, so source of this news is The Hindu. Next is the prohibited chemicals in firecrackers. It is important for GS paper 3. Topic is conservation and pollution related issues. So why it is in news? The Supreme Court is all set to go into an affidavit filed by the Environment Ministry last October on the use of so-called green and improved fireworks, hearing a case that could well decide whether this Diwali will see fireworks. What's the issue? The Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change has informed the court that a lot of research and development has gone into this field following the court's October 2018 judgment. It urged the court to consider the various proposals and formulations on the green improved crackers that the ministry has come up with in its affidavit filed before the court in October 2020. The judgment. The court's October 23, 2018 judgment banned the sale and production of firecrackers in Delhi NCR and regulated the use of firecrackers across the country. Barium-based firecrackers were specifically banned. Online sale of firecrackers has been completely banned. The verdict had come in response to a plea seeking a ban on manufacturing and sale of firecrackers across the country to curb air pollution. Recent observations made by the Supreme Court on the use of firecrackers. The Supreme Court said it cannot infringe the right to live of other citizens under the guise of employment of you while considering a ban on firecrackers. Have to strike a balance between employment, unemployment, and right to life. How do that is why, you know, social justice, economic justice, political justice, and environmental justice all are important. You can't just promote social or economic justice at the expense of environmental justice. And also, environmental justice has to go hand in hand with the social and economic justice. Okay, so that is why the Supreme Court has said this. That said, it cannot infringe the right to life of other citizens under the guise of employment of few while considering a ban on firecrackers. So how do firecrackers work? Firecrackers use fuel and oxidizers to produce a combustion reaction, and the resulting explosion spreads the material in a superheated state. The metal salts in the explosive mix get excited and emit light. So what is the controversy? Metals in the mix, which have a varying arrangement of electrons and shells outside their nucleus, produce different wavelengths of light in this reaction, generating spectacular colors. But as many studies show, the burning of firecrackers is an unusual and peak source of pollution made up of particles and gases. So they release 120 times strontium, 22 times magnesium, 12 times barium, 11 times potassium, and 6 times copper in 1 hour. Okay. So similar episodic spikes have been recorded in China and the UK. Pollution from the firecrackers affects the health of people and animals and aggravates the already poor ambient air quality in Indian cities. So can green crackers make a difference? So the Council of Scientific and Industrial Research, through its National Environmental Engineering Research Institute, NERI, Nagpur, has come out with the firecrackers that have reduced emission light and sound and 30% less particulate matter using potassium nitrate as oxidant. These crackers are named safe water releaser, which minimizes potassium nitrate and sulfur use but matches the sound intensity of conventional crackers, safe minimal aluminium where aluminium use is low, and safe thermite crackers with low sulfur and potassium nitrate. So prelim short link is, what are the green crackers, main products used in their manufacturing, what gives colors to the firecrackers. So the original article is this, you can read this. Okay, so next is the Real Estate Regulatory Authority Act of 2016. So GS paper 2 topic is welfare schemes for the unilevel sections. Okay, so why it is in news? The Supreme Court has stepped in to protect home buyers from exploitation by builders who delay transfer of possession and often redraft delivery schedules. So need for a petition was filed on the lack of a uniform or model form for agreements entered into among builders, agents and buyers. The petition said the Real Estate Regularity Authority RERA Act of 2016 had hardly been implemented. Often hard-saved earnings of ordinary citizens who aspire to have their homes were invested, but many families became penniless, waiting for a roof over their heads that the builders had promised them. The petitioner drew court's attention to Section 41 and 42 of the RERA. Section 41 mandated the establishment of a central advisory council. Section 42 said the council would ensure the implementation of the act, drive major policy changes, assure that consumer interests were not thwarted by builders and promoters, and craft the faster growth of the real estate sector. The Real Estate Regulation and Development Act 2016. It is aimed at bringing in transparency and redefining the engagement between various stakeholders. Key provisions: a requirement for developers to now register projects with RERA prior to any advertisement and sale. Developers are also expected to have all the sanction plans approved and regulatory clearances in place prior to commencement of sale. Next is the Act ambitiously stipulates an electronic system maintained on the website of RERA, where developers are expected to update on a quarterly basis the status of their projects and submit regular audits and architectural reports. It requires the developers to maintain separate escrow accounts in relation to each project and deposit 70% of the collections in such an account to ensure that funds collected are utilized only for the specific project. So the act also requires real estate brokers and agents to register themselves with the regulator. Significance of the act. The act has been described by the center as an attempt at cleaning up the real estate sector, ushering in transparency, accountability and fair play among stakeholders. This law will empower the consumer while boosting the credibility of the developers. It is widely felt that the act will shift housing demand, at least in the immediate term, towards the organized players, better equipped as they are to fulfill various stipulations. So prelims shortlink topics are about RERA, key provisions of the RERA, important organizations are established under it. The source is the Hindu and this is the original article, okay, you can read. Next is the Nobel Medicine Prize, GS Paper 3, Science and Technology is the topic. So why it is in news? US scientists David Julius and Artem Patapouchian have won the Nobel Medicine Prize for discoveries on receptors for temperature and touch. They will share the Nobel Prize check for 10 million Swedish honor, which is around $1.1 million. The pair's research is being used to develop treatments for a wide range of diseases and conditions, including chronic pain. About their discoveries, they discovered the molecular sensors in the human body that are sensitive to heat and to mechanical pressure and make us feel hot or cold or the touch of a sharp object on our skin. Julius discovered the first heat receptor. His work involved experiments with capsaicin, the substance that makes hot peppers hot, to identify a sensor in the nerve endings of the skin that responds to heat. So, significance of the disease discoveries. Breakthroughs in physiology have often resulted in an improvement in the ability to fight diseases and disorders. The identification of these receptors opens up the possibility of regulating their functioning. For example, there are receptors that make us feel pain. If these receptors can be suppressed or made less effective, the person would feel less pain. So about the Nobel Prize, the prestigious award comes with a gold medal and 10 million Swedish kronor over $1.14 million. The prize money comes from a bequest left by the prize's creator, Swedish inventor Alfred Nobel, who died in 1895. The Nobel Prize for Physiology or Medicine is awarded for discovery of major importance in life science or medicine. Karolinska Institute, now the Nobel Assembly at Karolinska Institute, selects the winner. Candidates eligible for the Medicine Prize are nominated by nominators who have received an invitation from the Nobel Committee to submit names for consideration. No one can nominate herself or himself. The source is the Hindu and this is the original article, you can read that. So next is the drone-based vaccine delivery model launched in Manipur. So it is a prelims specific topic. And ICMR's drone response and outreach iDrone was recently launched in Manipur. The delivery model is aimed at ensuring that life-saving vaccines reach everyone. This is for the first time that a Make in India drone has been used in South Asia to transport COVID vaccine over an aerial distance of 15 km in 12 to 15 minutes from the Bishnupur District Hospital to Loktek Lake, Karang Island in Manipur for administration at the primary health center. The actual road distance between these locations is 26 km. The delivery model would serve remote areas and hard-to-reach terrains. So this is the source of the news, this is the original article published in the Hindu, you can read. Next is the exercise Milan. So it is a prelim specific topic. India is set to host its largest naval exercise, Exercise Milan, early next year, for which 46 countries have been invited. The exercise will see the participation of all Quad countries. Milan has so far been held at Port Blair but is now being shifted to Visakhapatnam, which offers more space and facilities. So this is the original article, it is taken from the Hindu, you can read this. So thank you so much for watching the analysis video. Have a nice day.